So also my heavenly Father will do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother from your heart. Matthew 18, verse 35. Jesus had just finished telling the parable of the unforgiving servant. The servant had been forgiven a huge debt by the king, yet refused to forgive someone in his life that owed him a small amount of money. Let me remind you of two good reasons to forgive those who wrong you. The first is because you have been forgiven a huge debt. The Bible says that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, and that the wages of sin is death. Romans 6:23 and 3:23. In other words, we have not perfectly obeyed the will of God, and for that reason, we deserve to experience eternal death and eternal separation from God. However, because of His mercy, God has given to us what we do not deserve, forgiveness of our eternal debt, and in its place, righteousness, new life, and everlasting life. Because we have been forgiven a debt we could never pay, it makes sense for us to forgive others what small wrongs by comparison that they might be guilty of toward us. The other reason is because your actions impact you as opposed to those who sin against you. Let me explain. When someone sins against us, he or she will have to decide whether to ask forgiveness from God and from us. If they ask forgiveness, they will be forgiven and set free. If they don't ask forgiveness, they will carry the guilt of their sin going forward. Their decision impacts them. On the other hand, when someone wrongs us, we will also make a decision as to whether we will forgive them or not. They will not be punished if we choose not to forgive them. We will. We will suffer physically, emotionally, and spiritually because of our unforgiveness. Conversely, if we forgive those who wrong us, we will be set free to serve the Lord with a clean heart. My encouragement is that just as you have been forgiven much, forgive much. It's biblical, it's God-honoring, and it's spiritually healthy for you. Press on in the Lord.